Hey, what's up everyone, welcome back. Sorry if I sound weird, I'm sick, I have a cold. It looks like I'm starting to get better. But today we're gonna have a look at my settings. First of all, go into the settings and you go over to account and network. And then you can go to import settings. And here you can import your settings from either Cold War or Warzone. I have it from Warzone, import settings, boom. Now I have my Warzone settings in Vanguard, which is really, really good. So the graphics are just gonna scroll through the graphics here. This is what I'm playing with. And the quality tab, the game puts the best graphic settings your like computer can handle. So I'm just gonna scroll through this here. And as you can see, all the settings are almost maxed out and I'm having no issues with this. So I'm just keeping it like this. I usually go really low in settings so I can keep my FPS high, but it's working perfectly here. However, in Warzone, it's a whole different story. Gameplay, my field of view is 120, and I'm playing on ADS field of view affected. This camera movement thing, default 100. Pretty sure this is gonna make your screen shake around a lot when there's like bombers and airstrikes and shit going on. Definitely put this down on 50%. I have my motion blur, weapon motion blur, everything off. NVIDIA Reflex low latency is apparently on instead of on plus boost. Just gonna keep it like that. With the volume, you can just keep this at what it is. I just cranked it down because it was way too loud and I turned off the music. Hit marker volume is apparently on 75. My audio mix is on home theater. Home theater has been the best setting for me in Warzone, so that's what I'm keeping here. And yeah, I'm just gonna scroll through here. Nothing more important here, I guess. Yeah, voice chat volume, I turned it down because it was crazy loud. So the interface, is there anything important here? Not really. Here's my controller settings. So my input device is obviously on controller. I'm on a PC with controller and I got two pedals on the back. So my sensitivity, I'm playing on 12-12. This is something that I played on for the longest right now. I played on this on Warzone. This has worked perfect for me. You also have this custom sensitivity per zoom. You can keep this off and just keep the default settings. But if you turn this on and open this thing up, here you can set different ADS sensitivities. From the low zoom to the 3x, I'm keeping this on 0.80. And I played around a little bit with this. For sniping right now, it feels really good on 1.10. So I've just bumped all these up to 1.10. Playing with the Carnage right now, and it feels really, really good. The sniping is on point. And my bottom layout is on stick and move. This is also a setting that I played on for a really long time. I think I started playing with this in Black Ops 3, Black Ops 4. And since then, I've just been rolling with this, and I love it. This setting right here, I know a lot of dudes play this on flipped. I don't do it. Not messing around with that setting. And all these settings down here, blah blah blah. Aim response curve type is on standard. My controller vibration is off. What do we have down here? ADS sensitivity transition timing is instant. Multiplier on default. Default. This is also default. And the dead zones right here. I felt in the beginning when I started playing this game that it felt like I had a lot of input delay. It was these settings down here. So I think these were all the way up to 99 or something. And these were on like 20. So I bumped them down. I played the dead zone on 3. But I feel like I have a little bit of stick drift. So I bumped it up to 5. And it's really good right now. And the rest is just default. So that's all my settings right there. There's a lot of settings here. I almost forgot about the gameplay ones. This is pretty much all on default. I keep the mantle off because you know when you're in a gunfight and your character starts mantle, that's the worst thing. Keep it off. I don't really like automatic attack sprint with shotguns and akimbo pistols. In Warzone, I don't like automatic attack sprint, but here I keep it. Slide behavior is definitely on tap. Makes it a whole lot smoother to slide cancel. Here's also another setting that I had to change. Interact slash reload behavior. It's on tap to interact by default, I'm pretty sure. Switch this to tap to reload. Just gonna make your life a whole lot better. And those are all the settings. I'm currently working on the Carnage right now. It's a grind. I don't know how many levels the Carnage has, but this is the barrel that I won. You unlock this at 68. I played with this Carnage for a long time right now, and I popped double XP tokens. So it's definitely a grind to level up guns. In my opinion, I really think it takes way too long. So this is the class that I played around with a little bit. And here's the shotgun class that I played around with as well. This shotgun is busted, man. I mean, if you're in a building and people start pushing you, it's just over. It's almost a one-shot kill every time. Also, I have a question for you guys. This is pretty much the same engine as Modern Warfare, but it's slightly different. It feels like it's a little bit slower, not as aggressive as in Modern Warfare. In my opinion, it feels like there's a little bit of delay in everything compared to Modern Warfare's engine. Do you think this feels better than Modern Warfare? What do you prefer? I'm really curious to know, but yeah, other than that, hope you guys did enjoy it, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Later.